Dear friends, first of all, wish you a very happy new year and may you all have a very healthy, peaceful and progressive new year 2021. I am very happy to address you as we start afresh after a year that forces us to accept unprecedented challenges and come back strongly by turning them into opportunities. I must, however, be very careful to claim victory as the crisis is not over yet. I take this opportunity to salute the tremendous work done by the frontline workers around the world, the doctors, the nurses, others in the hospitals, pharma supply chain, police and government officials, social workers, scientists, our own political leaders. All of them have worked together extremely hard with the right intentions to serve the mankind in these extremely difficult times. Let us also share the sorrows with the families of those who lost their loved ones. Let us pray for the welfare of the others who are suffering. It's a great pride to all of us that few of the pharma companies have come up with a vaccine which has been successfully tested and is being introduced to the general public. Let us salute all those heroes who must have worked tirelessly in their laboratories around the world. Over the last few months, to come out with a vaccine against COVID-19 in such a short time, quite a remarkable achievement. This shows how much mankind can do when they are determined. This is a great lesson for all of us too. If we truly set out to achieve what we wish in our life, we can do it, whether it is our professional or personal goals. I take this opportunity to thank all our dear COVID warriors who have done some remarkable work by keeping business and operations running across our NVOCC business, CFSs, project sites, repair facilities, distribution centers, warehouses, and site offices. I also acknowledge and thank many of our esteemed sales personnel who kept their rigor in to ensuring that business continues to flow. There are so many frontline staff members who risk their health to ensure that the company's business continues. I salute their courage and dedication, which truly deserves a big round of applause. Over the years, our strategies and activities have been aligned to the theme Innovate and Reinvent. It is an approach that was exactly what we needed last year, and I'm sure will hold us in good stead going forward as well. The world collectively has been thrust into a new normal way of life and business. The only way to be prepared is to be flexible, agile, and ready for change. 2021 will be a year of transformation. But as we step into 2021, let's learn lessons from the human excesses which led to this colossal humanitarian crisis in 2020, which is likely to go far beyond 2021 in the medium to long term. Although it appears that the end of the crisis is visible in terms of the virus itself, since the world has started to vaccinate all the high-risk individuals, but let us not forget, the long-term impact may come back to hound us in the form of very high global debt, which most governments are carrying on their balance sheet, which many predict cannot be sustainable. Eventually, time will tell, but it's better to be prepared for that so we are not taken by surprise if another global financial crisis crops up in the short to medium term. Maybe most of the prudent organizations are already talking and doing something about it. One of the most important factors will always be to remain little paranoid and be frugal while spending and investing. It is logical to play safe, prudent, and help develop sustainable goals, and that is what I believe is the right thing for us to do. We should carefully evaluate the opportunities that come our way. Talking a little bit about my own life in 2020, I did a lot to remain in good shape physically and mentally in spite of the huge fear of uncertainty and various other stressful challenges. Having built a great team of leaders and employees, backed by my own abilities, I am far more relaxed about where we are with some extraordinary work that happened in 2020. One of the most unexpected surprises for me has been my appointment as the chairman of the Society and Board of Governors of National Institute of Industrial Engineering, popularly known as NITI. I carry this responsibility with a great amount of commitment to make a difference to this institution and to the society. In the process, help to churn out many more extraordinary leaders, which is renowned for. NITI has a track record of developing some of the greatest corporate societal leaders, and I see as an opportunity to reach out to them and engage our collective network during my chairmanship and my tenure in this role. I am honored with this appointment. I thoroughly enjoyed interacting with over 600 students online, visiting the campus, meeting faculty members, and connecting with the eminent alumni network based across the world. I believe that these interactions with students, faculty, alumni, and my own professional network and organization have set stage for winning industry academia partnerships in the coming months and years ahead while I lead this institution. I have pledged to do my best to set a path for the future management and the Board of Governors when my term comes to an end after 4 years. I am very proud of the director, the deans, the faculty members, and the administrative staff who have equally committed to do a great job to enable the institution to scale new heights. With an eye on the future, India is transforming into a strong manufacturing hub for itself and for the world. The country is heading towards building a self-reliant India. On the foundation of clearly visible recovery and upswing in the economy, India will soon be back on track, moving towards becoming the third largest economy in the world by 2030. It is up to each one of us to do our best and help keep the business moving to contribute to this growth. With the world still reeling under the impact of COVID-19, the pressure seems to have done well in terms of its foreign trade, helping our group to continue marching forward thanks to some of the most prominent and well thought out actions initiated early in 2019. These have been instrumental in keeping the company lean and fit, which I believe is the most important reason why we have been able to reach where we are today. As 2020 came to an end, it marked completion of a year since our strategic acquisition of Gati. We did not have the smoothest of starts, but our progress has been outstanding. The cultural amalgamation of Allcargo and Gati has been incomparable, and I am thankful to all our board members and senior leaders for the commendable effort. With Project Voyager at Allcargo and EQ Worldwide and Project Avashya at Gati in the throes of action, we are digitally enabling processes, optimizing operations, and accelerating sales across India and globally to be future-ready innovators. In many initiatives, we have made significant headway. 2020 saw Zoom, Google Meet, and Microsoft Teams weave their way into our life, and 2021 will get us even more tech savvy. Progress in 2021 will be driven by speedy advancements in technology, and success will belong to those who can keep pace, innovate, and reinvent. Blockchain, robotics, Internet of Things, etc. will possibly enter our life and conversations in a big way. We are looking ahead to create centers of excellence that will help us leverage them. Additionally, EQ 360 version 2.0, the cornerstone of our digital play, is transforming global logistics with door-to-door deliveries in 57 countries and seamless, convenient solutions. As always, every year, in the beginning of each new year, we are entering 2021 armed with strength and capabilities to offer end-to-end global logistics like never before. An international network through EQ Worldwide, covering more than 180 countries, Gati's domestic inroads into more than 19,800 pin codes in India, and our combined expertise across diverse logistics verticals create unmatched synergies. We should concentrate efforts to collaborate and establish leadership globally. Collaboration in 21 will not be restricted to our own teams. Considering increasing customer expectations and fast evolving new business models, we will have to partner with and learn from peers as well as nimble, cost-effective startups offering niche solutions. We have to learn a lot. While it may be a new year, it's best that some old things don't change. Our DNA of reliability, which customers have come to count on over the years, should only get stronger. In terms of a customer centricity, we must follow what Aristotle said: we are what we repeatedly do. Excellence then is not an act but a habit. At work, multiple stakeholders will be our priority. But in the coming year, I want you to also focus on you. Take care of your physical and emotional well-being. I say, as always, would like to urge all of you to aim high and go all out to achieve your goals at work and in your personal life. Wherever you go, always volunteer to help and nurture people, communities, and our planet. I wish each one of you once again a very happy and prosperous new year. May God bless all of us and the Avasya Group. Thank you very much.